Well, traders, I just decided I'm not going to continue trading today. There's my account. You can see that I'm up in Boeing and $2,500. I did not take that with a large size, but I'm still open with like $500 or so in Boeing with 200 shares. My best trade today is ZM. Qualcomm is a relatively small winner, and I've got a loser in BIIB. So I'm gonna finish up just over $9,000 with my open trades, getting close to 10 grand or so. So that's a fine day for me. I just want to discuss a little bit what happened today with the S&P and my best trade, possibly ZM. But I'll start with Boeing, because I think Boeing was very interesting for me, because it was like a very quick decision to move in, and I think I owe you some kind of an explanation there what happened. You may just remember when I started trading today, I posted Boeing for a short right over here. I missed this trade, it came down, crashed down. That was an amazing trade. I could have started with a few thousand dollar winner here, but I missed it. Anyway, I was watching Boeing coming down, looking at it, kind of crying to myself, how come I missed this trade? And then look at how beautifully it moved up. Now, you need to notice the following. Look at the S&P 500. The S&P came down right over here. That was the lows right there. If I'm gonna check out the time, it's 9:37. Look at Boeing here. That's 9:37. You can see that the Boeing's touching the lows exactly when the S&P does. Exactly at the same point. Now, exactly at the same point, 9:38, when the S&P starts to move higher, Boeing immediately afterwards starts moving up with S&P. That means that the weakness in Boeing was really the weakness of the S&P 500. You always need to watch the S&P 500, because it always makes the first move, and then the stock follows. But something rather different happened in Boeing today. Well, first you see that the S&P moved up, but not dramatically. I mean, moved up, didn't even close the gap. On the other hand, you can see that Boeing, which is stronger than the S&P, came up, closed the gap, turned green, moved sideways, looking for kind of an excuse to move higher. Look what happened here. Right here, that candle here is 10:25. Now look at what's happening in the S&P 500, 10:27. So actually, the first green candle you see here at 10:25, but it came down, and there came a red candle, and then the next one, 10:27, another green candle. At 10:27, what's interesting to see in Boeing, 10:27 was here. See, 10:27. Boeing was already very close to the highs. That's when I pointed it out as a long trade. I posted it in the trading room for a long over 140.60. I noticed that the S&P is starting to move higher. I didn't know if the S&P is going to move over the highs, but I certainly saw some nice green candle. The S&P was kind of here. At that point, Boeing was already at the highs. So it looked to me like if it's Boeing going to move over the highs, it's going to be a nice looking trade with some market support. Again, the S&P was moving higher. That's why I posted it in the trading room, a beautiful breakout formation, and it just continued, and that's a really lovely trade. So, you know, in this case, you can see that Boeing is certainly moving with the market. Any pullback you see in the market, like look at this one over here, it just came over here, the way the market moved up. But Boeing is stronger than the market, meaning more buyers than sellers than the S&P has. Anyway, that was a nice entry point, and I think that is something, if you're watching the S&P and you're watching a stock that you're trading together, you get a better idea of where you should go. On the other hand, had a nice short in ZM. Let's take a look at ZM. So if you're taking a look at ZM, just like the market, started with a gap down, although it tried to move higher at first, but then came down with the market. Approximately the same idea. But you can see that the market started moving up at 10:27, or sorry, 9:38. Sorry, 9:38. Market S&P started moving up. On the other hand, if you look at ZM, at the same time, 9:38, it popped up a bit with the S&P 500, but then decided it's going to come down, meaning again more sellers than buyers. So when you have one stock that is moving with the market, like BA has more buyers than sellers, it's trending higher. But when you have ZM, more sellers than buyers, it could pop up with the market, like this green candle here, when the market's moving up. But then again, more sellers than buyers. So when the market's making a small pullback, ZM takes it much more seriously and moves to a new low. So I spotted ZM here for a short, 140.30. That's where I posted it in the trading room. When it tried to move higher, it failed and then came down again. And of course, as you can see, that ZM has more sellers than buyers. That's why I also added twice as it came down. And that's why I've got a $9,000, almost $10,000 winner really in ZM. So ZM, actually exactly $10,000 winner, because with my open trades, it's like almost 10 grand. So really, my day is based on a good trade in ZM and just some winners and some losers in other stocks. I'm going to finish with three winners, one loser, and I just wanted to discuss ZM and Boeing with you because I think they were both significant. And that's it for me. I saw that several of you guys traded with me today, especially the ones I missed, the two beautiful trades I missed when the market was open today. And anyway, it was a good trading day, a very good one for me. I hope for you too. I'll see you all tomorrow. Enjoy. And take care. Bye, traders. Thank you for being here with us.